So these people will have habit to get very easily irritated because they are the original creators. And you can understand the frustration. Like someone, a music director creates a music which is very good and everyone likes it. This is the original content. And someone starts just copy it, paste it, and you know, use it in their songs. You can understand the frustration the person has. But the thing is, with the Brahma is, you see, Brahma is not getting his ideas. He has to be very grateful to God, that Lord Vishnu, that he's getting the ideas. He's only the medium. So wherever your Rohini is, let's suppose Raghav has a Rohini in seventh house in the Taurus sign. So this is very sure that he's going to get the wealthy wife. And he should be very grateful about it. He should never boast about, you know, my wife is wealthy because I am there. You exist because of me. It is actually reverse. You are only the medium for that particular wealth of the wife. Like Raghav, for you, because of you, your wife will get rich. You're only the medium, or the partners will get rich. Seventh house matters, no? Or family will be there. This is a pattern you should see. You're only the medium over there. You're nothing else. That's what the Lord Vishnu says. You're only the medium. Nothing else. So people who try to control their knowledge, their creativity, just because they think they have done it, their creativity stops there. Their downfall starts from that particular point. They should be very careful about it. Because if you think you are irreplaceable, you should think, because I'm going to tell you stories now, how God made everyone replaceable in this world, even Brahma.
Sir, what was the fifth from Rohini you said?
Okay. Because the kids of Lord Brahma never respected him. They never followed the orders. So wherever the Rohini is, fifth from it is never going to follow the orders. Like for Raghav, his wife's kids, his kids is never going to follow the wife's principles. For example, let me give you more examples regarding this. For Cancer ascendants, their siblings, they should not expect anything, because they are not going to do anything for them. The only thing they will get from siblings is disappointment. For Taurus ascendants, they should never expect anything out of the maternal aunts and maternal uncles, or especially regarding their education. Taurus ascendant, if they're rising in Rohini, once in their life, they will go for help to the maternal aunts and uncles, and they will get refused. You should not ask for help from fifth for it. For Gemini ascendant, the person should never expect anything, any gain out of their students and relationship with the students. Otherwise, disappointment will come. Because there's a sign of Libra, and that's in the fifth house. Anything from the love life they will expect, the only thing they will get is a disappointment. Anything they will expect out of the kid, there is a disappointment. You take any ascendant, you see where the Rohini is, the fifth from it, there is a disappointment. And once in life, you will go and ask for that, and then you will learn the lesson. Then you will learn that I should not have asked for it. Yes, ma'am. Now the people say, if you search on internet, you will find out, people say they are beautiful, they like perfumes and all these things you will find. But eventually, it is not the beauty. Let's suppose I would go and visit Dr. Arunji, okay? And I say, Arunji is very, very good looking person and he's very good. But the way Arunji speaks is very harsh. Am I going to visit Dr. Arun again? Never, I'm going to do it. So more than the external beauty, it is the internal beauty of the person. It is the internal interest of the person. It is the way the person is going to take care of you. So you will find, like Moon has 27 wives. Why only the Rohini is the favorite wife of the nakshatra? The story is, Moon only likes to live with the Rohini, and he will never visit the other 26 wives. And the other wives started complaining that, you know, you go and stay there only and never comes to us. What is that Rohini has? Because they think that she's beautiful, but that's not the truth. The thing is, Rohini is very caring, very nurturing, and she is not troubling him for small reasons. A partner, when it's a relationship, you want to spend time with the person who is going to take care of you, who understands you, and who understands things even when you're not saying it. You see, when people, they are in very deep friendships, or when they are very bad enemies, both, they do not need words to talk to each other. Like, there must be cases with all of you that you have friends, when you look at them, you know what has happened. You are at same frequency. You do not need words anymore. You can just convey it by their sign language, or just by looking at each other, you know what is the sentence you're making up. So that is what the Rohini is. Rohini is also the InfraSonics. That's a nakshatra for InfraSonics, that you do not need to talk to anyone else. Rohini does not need to talk to Moon to convey the feelings or understand the feelings of Moon. She knows by the mood of the Moon what she wants, how she wants, when she wants. This is how the Rohini and Moon interacts. While the other wives, they ask questions. And Moon being so moody, you see the Cancer ascendant, you ask him the third question, you will get a very bad reply. Very simple technique. Because Cancer ascendants never like to give you answers. And that's the problem with the Moon. Other wives do not understand the language of the mind. Rohini does. So Moon never visits anyone else. Moon stays with the Rohini for a longer time period. He spends time. And Rohini is the youngest wife because the other wife thinks, this is what the other wife thinks. They think just because the Rohini is younger, that is why Moon is with him. That's not true. They have, instead of improving themselves, they started blaming Rohini. And something which you cannot control. If you are young, you are young, right? You will find, and you can use this technique, you will find the Rohini Nakshatra natives, they are very young in the room. They are the smartest people in the room. They are the youngest person in the room. That is why there is a lot of jealousy the other people have. Because what Rohini Nakshatra can create, and by the thought process, the other people cannot even imagine. They think because he is young, and from last 15 years we were there, we were trying to do this project, and this guy comes in and he finished in 3 months. How does that happen? So instead of improving themselves, they start blaming the other guy. Rohini Nakshatra natives, wherever your Rohini is, you're the smartest person in the room for that particular reason. Like for a seventh house, someone had seventh house Rohini. We know that he's going to get a very younger wife. If someone else is jealous, that's his mistake, not his mistake. No, not the mistake of Raghav, that Raghav got the youngest wife in the whole family, or very beautiful wife and very capable wife in the whole family. That's what he is there for. And he's the smartest person when it comes to money. He knows how to manage the finances. Raghav, where are you?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm predicting for you. At least say yes, no.
I'm listening.
Okay. Is it true or not?
Regarding the financial part, I'm learning.
Okay. And regarding the marriage part?
I'm still finding my part. Okay. I don't know. Okay. But yeah, so one common trend is whomever I have dated, they are very rich than me till now.
Okay. Well, yeah. Well, that is one thing you are blessed with.
Okay.
Okay. So you don't have to worry regarding that.
You said regarding the younger who will achieve more. So I know a girl, she is Rohini ascendant. Mm-hmm. And Ketu is in ascendant, Rahu in seventh house. Mm-hmm. She is a unique case in entire office. She joined like 2 years back. Mm-hmm. Now she is at the top of the organization. Mm-hmm. And some people are working in that organization from past 8 years, 9 years, but they are still there. But she has jumped the ladder. Now people are jealous of her. Mm-hmm. Second thing is, she is very calculative about her relationship. she, it's like she weighs everything, ki which guy is smarter. I will date that person. I know this girl because she's very close to me. So she'll call me saying that I've got two proposals. One guy is rich, one guy is this. I'll go for this guy.
Okay. Yeah. But now you understand the energy, right? This is how the Rohini is working. Okay. This is not only we are just started with the Rohini now. Okay. Smartest person in the room. And when you're the smartest man in the room, the problem is people are jealous of you. People don't understand what you have done to achieve there. Like that girl, Raghav was telling, she has achieved top of the ladder. There will be other girls in the office. There will be other people in the office who are capable, but only she reached there. There has to be something special about it. People do not see that particular power of creation. They tend to make their own opinions. And for the Rohini Nakshatra natives, they should absolutely forget about any criticism, because they should not pay their ear to criticism. Because what happens is, criticism will affect them badly. Criticism will affect their creative part. Because if you keep, let's suppose someone is a singer or a music director or a writer, if a writer gets affected by the opinion of what the other people are saying, he will not write the original content. He will write what is going on in the market. He will write the same gibberish garbage part of it. He will never be able to write the best of the story which he was supposed to do. So you have to maintain the originality rather than thinking what the other people are saying. Let us suppose someone has Lord Brahma, when he started meditating and he started taking opinions of other people. Like if other people say the elephant should fly, the fish should be on the land, and you should do this. If you start taking other people's opinion in the head, this universe is not going to run. That is why they are very reluctant to any advices, whatever you're going to do, give to them. They already have their framework in mind. You are the original content creator over there. So do not bother about what other people are saying, because that's their job. Their job is to criticize you, copy you, steal from you, and do these things. But your job is to create content and give it out. That's why you are Rohini. You are not any other nakshatra. So when all the other 26 wives of the moon went to Prajapati, their father, they said, you know, our husband only spends time with the Rohini. Just because she is young, just because she is very beautiful, she is charming, and he never comes to it. So there will be always people who are complaining about you. There are always people who are spreading rumors about you. There are always people who will say things which are not true about you. But do not worry about them. Which I observed with Rohini, they will never ever wear tight clothing. They will always wear the loosest clothing that's possible for them. Very comfortable clothing they will wear. If you ask them to wear the leather pants or anything which is not loose, they're not very comfortable with it, with that type of a clothing. Raghav, that girl in your office. Can you confirm regarding the food and the clothing?
Okay, so I have a few things to share. She loves food. Okay, and once I criticized her for eating a lot, okay, and she stopped talking to me for 6 months. And regarding dress, she looks like a princess, I would say. Very elegant, and salwar, no jeans, nothing, only salwar.
Okay. Yeah. So now you know that you never ever tell the Rohini Nakshatra natives regarding the food. Because if you're going to tell them regarding food, you're creating trouble for them. Okay. Because that's their core part, to feed someone regarding the food. And also, it's not about eating alone. She will bring food for everyone. Cannot control Rohini until, except Saturn Rohini, except Saturn. Because what does bull likes to do? Whole day we like to roam around in his own area, eat grass. Whenever he wants to have sex, he will have sex, and then he will sleep. You cannot control him. That's what the Rohini is. Because for the creative people, if you put a schedule of them that from 9 to 5 you have to think, and from after 5 you cannot think. They cannot do these kind of jobs. They cannot be in that particular framework. Like whoever has a Lagan Ketu Rohini, if you ask that girl that you only work for this particular time period and do not work in, and after 5, she will go crazy. She will say, I cannot work like this. I work after 5, I work till 10, and some days I will not work at all.
Okay, so this girl is the special case where she doesn't work in a routine. People have said them work whenever you want. So she sometimes doesn't come to office, but she works whenever she feels like.
Now you should do her reading in a very wonderful manner, huh? Just from one nakshatra.
Yeah.
Now the thing is, these people will get offended if you tell them to work in a routine. Like there were days on shift when I just showed up and I said, I'm not going to do anything at all. For next 3 days, there is a bad weather. Do not wake me up. I will just not come out of the bed for next 3 days. And for some days, there will be 7 days of continuous job work. So this is the way Rohini will behave. They are not going to follow your routine, because an artist cannot follow a routine. A singer cannot follow a routine. A poet cannot follow a routine. If you tell them a poet, okay, morning 9 a.m., you go and write this poetry. And after that, you shut down. That's not going to happen. Because his creativity can wake up at any point of time. That's what the Rohini does. So creativity has nothing to do with the timings. That's why these people are very late at times. They will take their own sweet time to do things. They have their own routine. And anyone who tries to guide them that this is the office work and this is the timing, they will resign. They will simply resign and say, no, I'm not going to do it because this is not the way I'm going to work. Lord Brahma thinks because of him, the whole universe works. And he said, you know, let me take a sleep. The whole world will go to sleep and I will wake up and manage everything. Because I am the creator. I am the one without whom nothing can change in this world. Nothing can be made. So he went on asleep. By that time, there was a Brahmin and his family living on the earth. They have 10 kids. And feminine occur. And there was a disease also happened to the Brahmin. The Brahmin passed away with his wife. Now these 10 kids were very young. They didn't know much. And they said, what should we do in our life now? So they figured out that our father used to say that you have to go for the tap at this particular age. Let's go for tapasya on Himalaya. So they went out for tapasya to Himalayas. And they said, what should we wish for when we do the tap? Because you have to tweak the nimitta, that this is what we actually require. So they said, okay, let's become the king. But after, you know, they look at the state of the king and said, king is also not happy. So let's become the Brahma, because Brahma is the one who has created everyone. So they started doing tapasya, and very soon they reached the level of Brahma. There were 10 kids, and by the time they became the Brahma, they created 10 more universes and 10 more universe by the time Brahma wake up. So when Brahma woke up, he said, who actually created this? Because if I'm sleeping, who else can create these 10 universes? Then by his brain, he saw that what has happened. So if you think only because you can create something, only because you are the medium, the God has a plan to replace you. Now, Rohini Nakshatra natives, they get their thoughts original. There has to be someone who put their thoughts in the head. They get the thoughts from the God. They get things from the outer world. But they should not forget they are only the medium in this. They're not the creator. Someone else is helping them to create all this. The moment they get in the mode that I am the creator and nothing can be work without me, you will be replaced very soon. The moment that this particular thing goes in your head, you start becoming humble. Because if you think like Gemini Sutram, a wonderful text which has been lost. If you ever want to decode the secrets of astrology, try to rely on Brahma. He will give you a thought. You will become the medium. And then you have to share. But the moment you stop sharing your knowledge, the moment you become, hiding everything, that is the time your downfall will start. You will become irrelevant in the universe. Because if you're not going to go ahead and do it, Gemini Sutram is a wonderful text. But there are only four available, four are missing. Right? But it is somewhere there in the universe. If universe wants Raghav Shatabdi, Dr. Arun Negi, to go in and teach the Gemini Sutram, he will find a way. He will give you continuous bombarding of thoughts that this is the way it is working. You need to go in and test it. And you will become the medium. But if let's suppose Raghav says, I'm not going to teach it. I'm going to hide it. Raghav will become irrelevant with the time. So be very careful when you have, especially the occult houses, fifth house, or any of the knowledge houses you have, or knowledge planet you have in the Rohini Nakshatra. Do not ever think you are the only one who are getting these thoughts, because the universe will send thoughts to several people. But only the person who is ready to share them will get the blessings of the universe. Believe in the universe and you'll see how the thought process, someone will start helping you throughout the way. Yes, sir. Who is it? Saturn and Rohini, Surendraji. Okay, I think it's not there. Hanji.
So, like the context you explained, actually, I experienced today. Today, I was making one prediction, and ninth house Rahu was there.
Okay.
I don't know how it came to my head. Like, suddenly I told the person, like, you should not abuse Muslims.
Ah, wonderful.
So I don't know how it came. I was like, from morning, I'm wondering about that only, how it came. Like,
this is starting. If you started experiencing in that zone, Vinay, this is just starting. You will find how the universe works and it will send you several messages, not one.
Yeah.
Throughout the readings, throughout the knowledge, throughout teaching, it will give you knowledge which is beyond your expecting. Like all this knowledge, this is nothing is written in the book, right? Rohini Nakshatra. There's no book of it. So what I'm relying on the universe. The universe is going to help me, because I'm only the medium. Very soon I will be replaced. If let's suppose I do not teach you, I hide something. Very soon universe will find another one and says, okay, you do it. So the knowledge will find a way out. You cannot control it.
Sir, one feedback, sir. Sir, in two lectures, Bharani and Rohini,
yes, ma'am.
You just solved my 30 years of my life altogether. And like, I cannot thank you, just like I don't know how to thank you, but I'm really thankful to you. And sir, you
reflected by only Rahu, Saturn and Ketu?
Only Saturn. Only see, Rahu and Rohini will give you creativity, but in odd ways. Like these people will drink a lot and then will start. Saturn and Rohini, this particular person needs to drink alcohol. whiskey especially.
Okay.
To get into creative zone.
Okay, sir.
Like for me, it's a Mars, right? Mars and Rohini. I tell you, yes. Mars, it's very competitive. For me, it has to be the challenge. Like Mohanji, whenever he calls me, na, it's the biggest challenge for me. Because he will tell me that I have met this astrologer today and he is this. And this is how he predicted. The next day, I had to do the reading. Because to beat him. And I will take the screenshots and I will send it back to Mohanji. And I will say, now can he beat this? Because it's a competitive now. I cannot sleep. Very wonderful thing. This is not written anywhere. But I'm telling you from the experience that Rahu has blue eyes.
Okay.
You have to use this in prediction. There's no book which tells Rahu has blue eyes. Very squinty, sharp eyes. Sharp nose. Horns on the head. There's a crown on the head which is three points. Yes. He's sitting on a sofa which has three legs, but it is not big enough to be the three-seater. It is not big enough to be two-seater. It is just 3/4 of it. And he's sitting in a very odd shape, and he's lustrous, and he has only lustrous till this point. Below bodies does not have any kind of a illumination. And you look at him and there is a fear in your heart, because that smug face. See, smug face is a quality of Rahu. Because of that smug face and that smile is so dangerous that it will give you a heart skip. Because you do not know what he is thinking and what he is about to do. He's that beautiful. How do I know this? If I'm going to get the classical text and get worried about that, what classical, there's no classical text about it, but I still know about it.
You won't be teaching this.
Exactly. But I know that this is the way Rahu looks. Because why? Because I saw that in dream.
Yeah. sir, I'm telling you one thing.
I think blue eyes will represent by Rahu in second house.
Second house or second lord.
Yeah, second house or second lord. Blue eyes.
Yes, sir.
So today's lecture is amazing.
Yeah, just beautiful.
Oh, unbelievable.
Hello, even honey eyes.
Understand everything. It's like gone really inside.
You mean that before lectures you were not understanding anything?
No, before lectures we were not matching to the frequency.
Okay. Yes. Now we are coming in.
Yeah, right.
I would like to share some feedback on last sir, time.
This is Rohini Nakshatra.
Just a minute. Yeah, yes, Kanika.
Last lecture, you shared a technique that you, if you have to see what would happen on the day of the marriage.
Yes.
So I looked at my mother's chart, and I don't predict because I know about her life. So there's nothing, otherwise the bias would come. So I look at her chart, and then I told her, I'm like, on the day of your marriage, one, you got into a dispute with the pundit or the priest, and the other, there was a shortage of food. And she started laughing. And so she said, yeah, with the pundit ji, it's true, because when he came, and in her side of family, they're all like straight shooters. So they talk very blunt. There's no sugarcoating of words. So when the pundit ji came, her sister goes, Pandit Agya. And the Panditji got angry and they had to pacify him. And the other thing was shortage of food. So they had to travel to another place because her mother-in-law had fallen sick. So her in-laws had done on all the arrangements of food. But the doli was in the morning and they forgot to arrange the breakfast. So the breakfast had to be, then they had to go to the nearby shop, and she's like, we had chole bhature for breakfast because there was no proper arrangement. But that, I've been trying that technique you said on a few charts, so it's been working. Some of them I still need practice, so it's not working out, but it works. It's been those are fun predictions, actually. I had fun doing those.
Yes, I mean, see, that's what you start your consultations with, because that is what you get into the groove. Okay.
So feedback on the Rahu having blue eyes.
Yeah.
I studied art, and they And like in the Tibetan versions, when they depict the gods, when they draw the eyes, that's mm-hmm. like when they're in meditation and half open. Mm-hmm. You know, they had a lot of people wondering why it was blue. Some of the gods were depicted with the blue eyes, and then some of the gods would not have blue eyes. And some of the art historians would say, well, it was up to the discretion of the artist. So maybe okay. the artist had really good Rahu.
maybe that's but see, this is, I'm very clearly telling you, it's not mentioned anywhere. It's not from the classical text. It's the dream part which I'm telling you. Okay. And most of the techniques which I've derived out is through the subconscious brain, because that's how the nature works.